The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
You know, it's actually a bot that goes in and buys all these tickets. And so our platform will prevent that from happening. And then you'll have the programmable resale, which allows you to set a cap on the price of the ticket and also participate in the actual revenue on the resale side.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Evan Gappelberg. He is the CEO of Nextech3D.AI. And Evan, it's good to see you again. How are you?
I'm great. Great to be back, Steve.
Yeah, so you talked a little bit about last time we chatted about this rollout that you're going to have for this two-phase blockchain ticketing rollout. And the two phases, you've kind of gone into a bit more detail here. So including this, what I found kind of interesting, this walletless ticketing solution. So maybe let's start there.
Yeah, what's great about the walletless blockchain ticketing platform that we're launching in Q4 is that it opens up the doors to everybody. So, you know, if you don't have a wallet, you know, a Coinbase or a Kraken or one of these crypto wallets, the blockchain ticketing doesn't really work. So we're launching a walletless blockchain ticketing where we act as the custodian. It's basically you get to use our wallet, and it turns compliance into a feature. There's going to be all-in pricing, anti-bot identity, and programmable resale. The anti-bot piece is actually really critical. If you think about concert tickets and how, you know, within seconds of them being released, they're all gone. They're all sold. How is that even possible? Well, it's, you know, it's actually a bot that goes in and buys all these tickets. And so our platform will prevent that from happening. And then you'll have the programmable resale, which allows you to set a cap on the price of the ticket and also participate in the actual revenue on the resale side. And then when you add our navigation, which everybody knows, you know, we have a whole navigation platform where you can navigate to your seat. We expect to see some real exciting news coming in Q4 as we release this, and obviously 2026 should be a breakout year as we scale.
In the news release, Evan, it talks about that you really designed this to be the maximum ease for consumers and also the maximum ease and protection for those that are selling the tickets as well. It sounds like you're trying to address some problems on both sides.
Yeah, I mean, there's a big issue today with ticketing. The FTC is actually going after secondary ticket suppliers like StubHub and Vivid Seats and Live Nation because of ghost tickets and scalping. And there's actually a lawsuit. The government is going after these bigger players because they're really not protecting the consumer. And if you actually try and buy tickets to popular shows, they're always sold out. You got to go to secondary platforms. So we're going to try and solve that problem with our blockchain ticketing solution. We think there's an opportunity for disruption, Steve. And we think that there's a significant opportunity for revenue. Our software, we target 70-80% gross margins. And we think, you know, there's just this massive opportunity. There's $85 billion worth of tickets sold annually. And we think it's ripe for disruption with digital ticketing and, of course, blockchain ticketing. If you think about sporting events, festivals, trade shows, that's only part of the ticketing solution. There's also the potential to offer blockchain ticketing, secure ticketing for travel. Think about your airline ticket. Think about a bus ticket. Think about a ticket for a train. So it extends beyond live events into other areas. And, you know, you're talking about hundreds of billions of dollars worth of tickets globally. And when you start using blockchain, there is no border. It's a borderless solution. It's a quite interesting way to offer a ticketing solution using blockchain. You end up with this platform that can create a secure solution with faster payouts using USDC. And again, it's borderless. So we're going to be launching, Steve, with MapD's 500 customers that we already have. And we expect to be able to gain some traction and show how this tech works in Q4.
Okay. And then really quickly, in 2026, phase two will launch, and that will give people more opportunity to control their own blockchain and ticketing as well. So it takes it, puts it right in their own hands.
Yeah. I mean, that's actually when this gets really interesting. Yesterday, I don't know if you saw the news, but Morgan Stanley came out and said that they're going to be launching a crypto wallet in early 2026. They have millions and millions of people on their platform. It's TD, or it's E-Trade rather. And so all the big banks are moving to these custodial wallets for blockchain. And so once that actually becomes the norm, we'll have the ability for customers to buy tickets, just transferring their crypto US dollar coin onto the platform. It literally takes, less than a minute. Yesterday I was using Coinbase and I was transferring some money. It took 60 seconds to transfer $1,000 and it cost 26 cents. 26 cents, Steve. Mm. If you think about the existing credit card companies, it takes way longer and it costs, 3%, which would be, yeah, 100 times as much as it costs on the blockchain. So yeah, there's a big, big opportunity here by using blockchain technology for ticketing. And we intend to take full advantage of that, Steve.
All right, Evan, we'll leave it there. Thanks so much. Good to see you again.
Thank you.
Evan Gappelberg, the CEO of Nextech3D.AI.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.